When I was a teenager, my parents moved to a new town. I had to go to a new school. There was one girl in my class who was really beautiful, and I would have given anything just to go on a date with her. In one of our classes, my teacher paired us up for a project, so we were finally gonna have to spend some time alone together. I figured this was my chance to finally ask her out. We worked on a project at her house, but I found out where she lived. I began to have second thoughts. She lived in a small wooden cabin in the woods. Her mother wasn't around, and her father really creeped me out. He seemed to be totally insane. He never said a word to me and acted as if I wasn't here. He walked around the cabin with his shirt off, drinking beer, chewing on tobacco, and carrying a shotgun in his hands. Seemed like the only thing he was interested in was hunting. The walls were lined with bear skins, animal heads, deer antlers, and skulls. It was extremely creepy. At school, one of my friends told me he had heard a rumor about the girl. He said that her father had killed her mother years ago, but the police were never able to prove it, so he got away with it. Apparently, the mother's body was found in the middle of town, riddled with bullet holes from a shotgun. He said the girl had to stay with her father because she had no other living relatives. The story, it really rattled me, but there was no way to find out it was true. I wasn't actually going to come out and ask the girl about it. Eventually, I managed to work up the courage to ask the girl on a date, and to my surprise, she said, yeah, it was a date. That night, I drove over to her place to pick her up. She answered the door wearing a short skirt, and she had done her hair and put on makeup. She looked gorgeous. Just as we were about to leave, her father took me aside and spoke to me for the first time. "You know what will happen when you if you touch her," he growled. Suddenly, the story about him murdering his wife was the only thing I could think about. I took the girl to a movie, and afterwards we went skating. All night, her father's threat were preying on my mind. I was terrified that his dad was gonna kill me when he got back to her place. Just couldn't get the thought out of my head. At the end of the night, I drove her back to her place. When we got to the house, she told me to park at the end of the driveway and turn off the headlight. She wanted a kiss. At this point, I managed to forget all about her crazy father. Leaned over and kissed her. Afterwards, I turned the headlights back on and noticed something strange. There was blood in the snow on the end of the driveway. At first, I thought I was seeing some things. She didn't seem to notice anything wrong. My heart was beating fast, though. Wanted to say something, but I didn't want to sound like an idiot. There had to be a logical explanation for this. I put the car in the drive and started down the long, winded driveway to her house. The trail of blood seemed to be getting thicker. I became more and more nervous. She still said nothing. She was fixing her makeup in the mirror. I kept driving, and all I could see was more blood. A chill ran down the back of my spine, and I broke out in a cold sweat. I turned the last corner as we pulled into her house. The headlights illuminated a figure standing outside. It was her father. He was standing there, covered in blood, and he was clutching a huge knife in his hand. There was something laying at his feet in a pool of blood. It looked like a body. Her father started to approach the car. I completely freaked out and started to hyperventilate. Suddenly, tears were rolling down my face. I'm embarrassed to admit it, but he even peed my pants. I'm sure he was gonna kill me. As it turns out, he had to drive me to the hospital instead. I was having a full panic attack. We found out later that her father had found a bear at the end of the driveway and shot it. He dragged it up to the house in the middle and was in the middle of skinning it when we pulled up. I also found that her mother wasn't dead. They're still together. Whenever I meet her father, he always brings up the incident and laughs at me.